joining me now in the studio is Representative Rob Matzie of Allegheny County to talk about the crisis that's currently facing the thousands and thousands of Pennsylvanians currently enrolled in the state's Adult Basic program. So, Representative Matzie, give us a little background for us, how we got to this point that we're really in trouble right now.
Well, it's really a multitude of things really transpired over the course of the last couple of years. When the tobacco settlement money came through that really started this program, it was considered a real windfall for those who work but don't have health coverage offered to them in their employment. So this really served to make up the difference for quite a few people. Even though we have a waiting list and a waiting list at the beginning, the waiting list wasn't that bad, and the turnover actually gradually over the course of about a year or so, people were able to get onto the list. But over the last couple of years, with such high unemployment and so many folks out of work and getting lower paying jobs or less jobs out there, the waiting list is up. It's almost at 500,000 people. And really what transpired is as the tobacco settlement money started to slip down, the General Assembly stepped in and was able to put money into the program and then worked out a deal with the Blues throughout the course throughout the Commonwealth. And that
Blues meaning the insurance
Blues,
companies.
The insurance companies. And the that deal will be expiring here and expired and will be done at the end of February. So there's nothing on paper right now as far as any potential deal with the Blues to continue with the way it was. They are going to offer a new program to transition people in, but with a much higher premium. Right now they're only paying $36. The new program will be well over $100, and for some folks that are working, that's just a little bit too high for them, right, to be able to afford. They have to make tough decisions. You know, they want to eat, do they want to have coverage and be able to take care of themselves with their health problems.
And you just mentioned working people, and you mentioned that right off the bat, that this Adult Basic program is for working Pennsylvanians, those who don't have another option for coverage, and that's all they can afford. So it's not talking, we're not talking about free handouts,
right,
here, but we're talking about this is what people can afford, and this is really a necessity. So to take that away is causing quite a backlash.
No question. It's not an entitlement by any stretch of the imagination. I had a constituent in my district office in Beaver County last week came in. Her husband already is eligible for Social Security. She's a tweener. She's in her late 50s. She's got a multitude of health problems, and she's on Adult Basic right now. She doesn't know where to go. And with the problems she has and the medication that she's on and the many doctors that she has to see, for her to transition from a $36 a month payment to now $136 or $160 a month payment, she's not going to be able to afford it. They're going to have to make major decisions on how they budget their monthly money and be able to make it. So this is life or death, quite frankly. And it's not a Republican thing. It's not a Democrat thing. It's the right thing to do. The Corbett administration needs to step up, and we need to work together as the General Assembly, as equal branches of government here, to come up with a program that works. Now, if the premium has to go up a few bucks, that's one thing. But to go up from 36 to 136 or 160, four times the amount, to expect people that are working and paying into the program until we can come up with a solution just doesn't make any sense.
Representative Matzie, we said that the federal government now may come into play in this issue, and how is that?
There's a couple of different things that could transpire. You obviously have the health care bill that passed in the Congress last session, and that's obviously being attacked on all ends in some parts of this country as well as in the courts, and they'll work that out, and some of that stuff will trickle down to the Commonwealth and to other states, I'm sure. One of the deals that's out there and one of the bills that's out there has been introduced by Representative Tony DeLuca, who's the chairman of the House Insurance Committee, the ranking member, and he is basically reaching out to the Corbett administration saying, why don't we borrow from the CAT fund, the catastrophic fund? They have a huge surplus right now, and by taking out a portion of that CAT fund, we can get us to June, get us into that next budget,
right,
year, and hopefully between now and the next fiscal year, we could work something out during the course of the budget discussions, or by then, hopefully, something can transpire at the federal level that will trickle down and help people out.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's back up to before Governor Corbett took office, when he was Attorney General, and he, along with other Attorney Generals across the country, sue the federal government because of was involved in a lawsuit with the other attorney generals about the health care plan on the federal level. But now to ask the federal government to pick up basically the loophole within the funding gap, how is it kind of, he said, he said?
Yeah, absolutely. Some people are saying it's hypocritical. I think that now when you find that as the attorney general and you look at one aspect of your job as the state's attorney and going after the bill, and now you are the executive branch, it's a little different. And to his credit, I think it's easy to throw darts and say that, hey, it is hypocritical. But to his credit, at least he saw the light maybe and says, hey, we need some help here. And maybe there is a way to go. But I think he needs to really put the pressure on. He needs to put the pedal to the metal and really reach out to the federal government and reach out to the General Assembly and say, listen, we need to make this work. I need your help. So instead of us doing legislation that says the federal health care bill is a bad bill, we should be reaching out and doing something with the federal government, asking the federal government, hey, we need your help with this program. We need you to get together and make this about policy and not politics, and the partisanship pushed aside now, and let's govern, because that's what we're here to do. Let's govern because it's the right thing to do. It's for the people. It's not about politics.
With that said, Representative Matzie, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure. Thanks, Stephanie.